Hi, I'm Mrs. Caracas, and I'm excited today to introduce the first lesson for a new class called Integrated Art and Science. In Integrated Art and Science, we'll be working with borosilicate glass and lamp working technology to learn how to make glass art. Today's lesson deals strictly with safety. Before we can turn the torch on, students need to learn about the physical work environment as well as their own personal environment so that they are able to safely turn on the oxygen propane torch and begin with the exciting lamp working lesson. Let's start now by talking about physical space safety and awareness that students should be knowledgeable about. First, materials used are an oxygen tank and a propane tank. Both of those tanks need to be securely attached to a wall, and they need chained up, and they need to be 5 feet or further from the actual lamp working torch. Behind me, you'll see both my oxygen tank as well as my propane tank. Attached to the tanks, there needs to be a backflash arrestor next to the regulator. The regulator is simply a tool to let you know how much pressure is in the tank as well as how much gas is in the tank. The arrestor, however, is what will stop the gas from going back into the tank from the hose should there be some sort of reason for the gases to be sucked backwards. A backflash arrestor will prevent the explosion that would happen without it. So you never want to work ever without that piece of equipment. Another very important piece of equipment for the physical space is ventilation. When working, you need to make sure a ventilation fan is on. In the case of my studio, you will see a fan, and that is always turned on, sucking the air away, as you do not want to be breathing in the materials, the metals, and the oxides that are airborne when the glass has turned molten. That's about it for the physical space, and now for your own personal space. Definitely, hair needs to be back if you have long hair. The last thing you want is it to go forward into the flame. Closed-toed shoes are imperative, as molten glass should never be dripping, but if it were, you wouldn't want it on your feet, specifically on open-toed shoes. No lip gloss or lipstick, as particles will be sticking to your mouth if they are airborne, and that is something you do not want. And lastly, safety glasses. These are shade 3 borescope glasses made specifically for blocking solar flare that will burn your retina. So you never want to do any sort of lamp working without proper eye protection. So that would be what is necessary for both a physical environment as well as a personal environment. One last thing I want to mention is a rolly chair. You're able to roll into and away from the torch as need be. And that rolling chair will sometimes enable you to move fast as you need to, because glass has a life of its own. I hope that you've learned some safety tips. And now, as I'm about to turn the torch on, always the propane before the oxygen, I would like to welcome you back to the next podcast to learn more about safe and fun lamp working.